So it was about a year ago now that my friend Mike and I were planning a 1 month trip through India. Now I had seen beautiful pictures of India, but at the same time, I'd also heard stories about how it's dirty and busy. Honestly, I really wasn't sure what to expect going into this trip, but I did know that I wanted to see it for myself. So we ended up booking a pair of tickets to India's largest city, Mumbai. And that is where our crazy adventure began.
Are you ready?
As ready as I can be.
Thank you.
We landed in Mumbai around 11 p.m. and within minutes we learned that nothing in India works as it should.
We've made it.
From the lines that we waited in at the airport going through customs to the Ubers that just never showed up. Everything in India seemed to work in its own way on its own time. By the time we made it to our hotel, it was like 4 a.m. and the two of us were just super tired. We wanted to get to bed. So we made it into our room and...
within the first 15 minutes, we blew the fuse, so we have no power now. We found a cockroach that's living inside of the AC unit. And we're in great spirits.
At this point, there really wasn't much else that Mike and I could do aside from laugh. We had no idea what we had just gotten ourselves into. Okay, so the first day was rough, but we were sure things would get better, right? Well, after having explored Mumbai for a couple days, our first impressions of the country were just like people had said. It was busy and it was dirty. People, cars, and buses were everywhere running all the time, and for two Canadians, it was a bit of sensory overload. By now, Mike and I were done with the city, and we were beginning to worry about what the rest of our trip was going to look like. Luckily, someone suggested that we hop on a train and head down south to check out the beaches, and Mike and I were all over that. We ended up meeting some cool people, we had some really good conversations, we drank some chai tea, and the train, it dropped us off exactly where we needed to be. Arriving at the beaches turned out to be a breath of fresh air, which is exactly what Mike and I needed after escaping the bustle of India's largest city. It kind of opened our eyes back up after those intimidating first couple days and showed us that there was definitely so much more to uncover during the rest of our trip. One of my biggest worries about traveling to India had to be the food situation, as I had heard horror stories about tourists dealing with food poisoning.
Coconut chutney and sambal.
Yeah.
Okay. And what is it? It's like vegetables and
vegetable, yeah.
Okay. And then fermented rice, yeah. Kind of cake, yeah. Things. Cool. Perfect. Thank you.
As we continued our trip down the coastline, visiting a bunch of beaches, we eventually caught a plane that headed up north, which is when we experienced the food poisoning. And by we, I mean Mike. I was actually okay throughout our entire month in India, but Mike, on the other hand, he got hit pretty bad. But although the food situation in India can be a bit unsanitary at times, I have to tell you that the Indian food that we ate was some of, if not the best food I have ever had in my entire life. The food in India is world class. I actually spent my entire month eating like a vegetarian, which is not like me at all, but throughout the entire country, they prepared food in such a way that I didn't even notice. The flavors, the variety, the ingredients, the culture surrounding their food, everything about it was amazing. By now, we'd seen multiple cities and been through a couple different Indian states, all of which were vastly different from one another. One thing that reigned true throughout the entire country, no matter what city or what state we were in, was how nice the people that we met were. Seriously, one night Mike and I were walking by a temple when we were invited in to eat dinner with everyone. Another night, we boarded a train that had no stops for food, and I had forgotten to eat. And the family beside us heard that, and they brought me a plate of food. Another time, Mike's motorbike ran out of gas on the side of the road, and rather than driving past him, someone stopped and siphoned gas from their bike into his. We had countless experiences like that, whether we were hanging out on the beaches in the south, taking crazy trains through the mountains, or visiting the temples in the north. Throughout our entire 30 days in India, there was never one time where Mike and I felt unsafe or unwelcome. At this point, we had visited most of the places we wanted to see and done most of the things that we wanted to do. I started thinking about our trip and how after those first couple days, I ended up loving my time in India. I was trying to pinpoint what exactly made me change my mind. And ultimately, I think it comes down to their culture. You see, India is chaotic and things operate differently over there. You don't go to India for that relaxing vacation, which I think is the mindset that I had to kind of leave behind after our first couple days. But though it may not be relaxing, I have never been anywhere so culturally immersive, so kind, and so willing to share what they have, willing to share their incredible country. The immaculate historical sites, the delicious food on every corner, the colorful celebrations, and the beautiful clothing. You can't go to India without experiencing their authentic culture. It runs deep, and it runs through everything they do. By the end of our trip, we were able to put aside those minor annoyances and truly appreciate India for everything that it had to offer. It may not have been a relaxing trip, but it was the exact adventure that we were looking for. If you're heading to India and you have some questions, I've got you covered. After backpacking there for 30 days, I wrote down anything and everything that you may need to know before and during your trip. I put it all into a PDF that you can download to your phone so you have it with you as you travel. You can check it out at noahvde.com/store. Thank you so much for watching, my dudes. That was actually the second time I've recorded this thing. The first time, I forgot to turn on the microphone. Yeah. Feels bad. I hope you guys had an amazing holiday season. I know I have, spending lots of time with family and friends. It's been great. There is some exciting stuff coming up very soon, some big changes that are going to be happening in my life, and I cannot wait to take you along on the ride. Anyways, dudes, let me know what you thought of this video down below, and I'll see you guys in another one.